I'm curious.
You won't die.
Why do you have shaving cream?
Why don't you have shaving cream?
Have you ever seen the original Jurassic Park?
Yeah.
I wouldn't die.
Does any, everyone remember the shaving cream scene?
Oh.
No.
No?
I do.
What did they do with a shaving cream?
Do they wash the tables with it like you're selling peanut butter?
No. They hide the DNA in the can.
Oh,
right?
I remember that. Yeah.
I remember they switched the labels.
Yeah, they hid it in there so he could sneak the DNA out of the place.
And keep it bad right
guy. He was trying to do that. The bad guy. Alright, so how many of you seen the original Jurassic Park? Raise your hand.
I've seen every single movie.
Same.
All right. Jurassic Park got it all wrong. Well, they didn't get everything wrong. If anyone knows anything about dinosaurs, we know now that dinosaurs had feathers, right? How many? Anyone know the difference between like a theropod and this is like a T-Rex, an Allosaurus, a Velociraptor? Some of those had feathers. And another thing is a lot of facts didn't make it in from the book into the movie, right? So Michael Crichton wrote Jurassic Park in 1990, and at the end of the book, he acknowledges famous paleontologists for the research. Among those famous paleontologists was John Ostrom. Anyone recognize the last name Ostrom? Who else has a last name Ostrom?
Me. What do you think O stands for?
John Ostrom was my uncle, okay? So. This is the original Jurassic Park book written by Michael Crichton, and at the end he has an acknowledgement, and I was just going to read a little bit of that. It says, in preparation for this novel, I have drawn upon the works of many eminent paleontologists, particularly Robert Baker, John Horner, John Ostrom, and Gregory Paul. He continues to say that... However, this book is entirely fiction, and the views expressed here are my own, as are whatever factors, errors exist in the text. So, right in this book, he admits that there's errors. He purposely, fully, particularly with the star dinosaur. Who's the star dinosaur in Jurassic Park?
T-Rex.
Well, maybe.
The spider.
It was blue.
Right.
The raptors, like,
blue. Well, blue was in the Jurassic World. Before, they just had velociraptors, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to get back to Velociraptor in a little bit, but I want to talk about my Uncle John a little bit so you know who he was. So if you go into any library and look up dinosaurs, you'll find his name, and we have some of the books here, like obviously Jurassic Park. And this book here, you see...
Dinosaur books that we have in the library.
In the library, or any library you'd go to, you would see, you know, my Uncle John's name here. Talks about all the things he did, which is pretty cool, like any book you find. So, I remember as a kid visiting my uncle at Yale University and going there, and he'd take me in the back and show me all the dinosaur bones, and yeah, back in the 80s and 90s. And in the 1960s, John Ostrom discovered a ferocious dinosaur, a terrible claw. My uncle named this dinosaur Deinonychus. Anyone hear of Deinonychus before?
Yeah.
So this is a Deinonychus. And notice anything about the Deinonychus?
Isn't the Deinonychus the one in with the sharp claws?
Yeah, the sharp, terrible claw. Look at that. See? Yep, I actually have a replica of that. I was going to pass around. I'll go get that later. But so again, my Uncle John was a professor at Yale University in the 60s, way back in the 60s. And in 1964, he went on an expedition to Montana with his team from Yale. Noticing a bone protruding from the soil, he uncovered the remains of a two-legged creature with curving 4-inch claw on each foot. His team from Yale went back several times to excavate this fossil of this never-before-seen dinosaur, and they brought it back to Yale to study. So, before this, no one ever seen a dinosaur like this before, with a claw like that. So Deinonychus quickly became one of the most well-known dinosaurs. One thing that he noticed was that the dinosaur was very bird-like. He traveled to Germany to compare his discovery to the remains of the oldest known bird, Archaeopteryx, which flourished 150 million years ago. So anyone here have heard of Archaeopteryx before?
I have, because back when I was 6, I was hugely obsessed with dinosaurs.
Oh, yeah.
I had almost 20 books about it, and I would get it for my birthday. I was just obsessed with it all.
Yeah, that's awesome. Great. So he matched up the backbones, the limbs, the toes, and the pelvises, and the similarities astounded him. And finally, in 1973, he published his papers asserting his beliefs that birds, including Archaeopteryx, evolved from dinosaurs that had feathers not for flight but for warmth. While some Victorian scholars had noticed the similarities between birds and dinosaurs, Ostrom was the first scientist to collect physical evidence of the theory. This is actually in the book. Where is it? So let me see if I can find this real quick. This is pretty cool. So in the book, he actually has a scene here, which would have, I think they should have put in the actual movie. I think this is Grant talking. He says, scientists have had always classified dinosaurs as reptiles, cold-blooded creatures, drawing the heat they needed for life from the environment. A mammal could metabolize food to produce bodily warmth, but reptiles could not. Eventually, a handful of researchers, led chiefly by John Ostrom and Robert Baker at Yale, began to suspect that the concept of sluggish, cold-blooded dinosaurs was inadequate to explain the fossil record in a classified deduction fashion. They drew the conclusion from several lines of evidence that dinosaurs were warm-blooded. So isn't that pretty cool?
Mm-hmm.
So the difference between a reptile and a bird, birds are warm-blooded, like mammals. Dinosaurs, theropods, were warm-blooded. And we also know now that they also had feathers, right? So isn't that pretty cool? So my Uncle John is in this book. That never made it into the movie. So,
because you think of a dinosaur as a reptile.
A lot of people, yeah. But now I think now we know that they actually were closer related to birds and were the ancestors of birds, right? So.
Isn't that a dinosaur fish or still
a dinosaur fish?
Yeah.
Yeah, so here's the thing. The word dinosaur is loosely applied to a whole bunch of different types. A dinosaur is really a theropod, right? And then some other kinds of related dinosaurs, like the four-legged, they're still considered dinosaurs, like Triceratops. But a lot of, like a fish, that they would call it a dinosaur, but really it's a completely different, similar to some other, like a Dimetrodon was really not a dinosaur.
If I'm not wrong, the Dimetrodon was the one like with the heavy-headed plate, with the big tooth?
Dimetrodon?
Yeah.
A Dimetrodon had that big sail and looked on the back of it. Yeah. So, Spinosaurus also had a sail like that. Yeah. Dimetrodon Dimetrodon is actually a lizard, not a so a Dimetrodon was cold-blooded and was a lizard, not a dinosaur. Dinosaurs were warm-blooded. They became warm-blooded. So this was before, it was a giant lizard, but it was cold-blooded, so it wasn't a dinosaur, or it's before dinosaurs. Okay, so that's the difference. Okay, so moving on, where was I? So in the 1990s, new dinosaur fossils were discovered in China with feather markings similar to Archaeopteryx, which further proved John's theory that birds evolved from dinosaurs. One of these dinosaurs was given the name Microraptor, right here. So notice the feather markings and the fossils?
Yeah.
So that's Microraptor, and this is an artist interpretation of what the Microraptor looked like. So this was before a bird, similar to a bird, it was still a raptor, but it was like in between like a Velociraptor and an Archaeopteryx, right? So John was retired from Yale University by then, but he was able to go to China and study these fossils with the feathers, which is pretty cool. So in the latest Jurassic World movie, which some of you have seen, does anyone remember that dinosaur with feathers? Yeah, so it had that dinosaur with feathers. But the main part that Jurassic Park, the name, Deinonychus. Yeah. So the star dinosaur, Blue, was really a Deinonychus, not a Velociraptor, right?
Makes sense for his size.
Yeah, for his size. Because
he was way too big a Velociraptor
only grows to be 2 to 2.5 feet tall, like this, right? So here's a Velociraptor. Here's a Deinonychus. Okay, so a Deinonychus grows to be 4 to 4.5 feet tall, and the Velociraptor also has an elongated squished snout that goes like this. So it looks a little bit different. The Velociraptor fossil was discovered in August 11, 1923 by Peter Kazin. It was an incomplete skeleton, however. It just had the skull and one of the claws, and it wasn't even the big claw. It was just a middle claw, a raptorial claw, as it's described as, and that's why it got the name Velociraptor. Similar to like raptors you see today, like eagles are raptors, and hawks are raptors, which is pretty interesting. So there are several other raptors besides Velociraptor, Microraptor, and Deinonychus. There is one that looks a lot like Deinonychus, but grows to be 6 feet tall and 18 feet long. This is called the Utah Raptor Ostromaci. It was named after my Uncle John, 1975, by Jim Jensen. And this could be the one that's described in the book, but they call it Velociraptor, not Utahraptor. In the first movie, you notice the dinosaurs, and the new movies, they're like this big, right?
Because so it's starting to get it right a bit.
Yeah. So, but they're still not, they weren't all Velociraptors. Some were Deinonychus, some were Utahraptors, and some were other ones, yeah.
So that means it'd be a Velociraptor. So you know in that scene where like that little dinosaur comes up and the things like come out and he shoots like this black.
Oh,
yeah.
And you know, like the smaller, like Velociraptor-looking things that were with it.
Yeah.
So those must have been the real Velociraptors, since they were
barely up to here. Yeah. Those were pretty small.
Yeah. So those must have been the true Velociraptors.
Yeah, or a Microraptor. So.
But it had no.
So that's pretty interesting stuff, right? There's also one called a Pyroraptor. The one in the new movies is called a Pyroraptor, and that one was another one that was the size of a Velociraptor and had feathers. But that one in the movie, again, they made it like the size of a Deinonychus, right? It was like about this big. You remember that one that swam through the water. So why not call it Deinonychus? So who knows, maybe someday they'll make a new Jurassic Park movie and they'll actually name it Deinonychus. But we're not going to wait for that. We're going to make our own movie with the Deinonychus called the lost movie, The Deinonychus. All right, you guys ready to make a movie?
Yeah.
All right.
Jurassic Park. I will be your tour guide for today. Did you know we have dinosaurs all around us? We call them birds. Here we have a fossil of the first bird.
Yeah, it's called the Archaeopteryx.
That's right. Thank you. We are very lucky to have Dr. Alan Grant with us on our tour today.
So warm.
This is a Deinonychus cloud discovered by paleontologist John Ostrom. Come on this way.
Oh no, it's not good. I don't think it's a good idea.
This shows how big the Deinonychus is. For some reason, people mistake it for the Velociraptor, who only grows to be about 2.5 feet tall and 6 feet long. The Deinonychus is the type of raptor that grows to be about 4 feet tall and 10 feet long.
Deinonychus. There's also a Utah raptor, which grows to be about 6 feet tall and 16 feet long. Telling me you make real dinosaurs?
Yes, you for yourself.
Yeah, it's a Velociraptor!
That's not a Velociraptor. That's a Deinonychus. In that, see in that box? That's a Velociraptor.
It's a Deinonychus. Who cares? Your Deinonychus gonna eat you!
Run!
Discovered by paleontologist John.
These are great bloopers.
Look at the good
peeking out the door.
I'm on the wrong page. Oh, this is my paper.
Come
and
then on.
He's gonna turn a corner. There's two of them.
That's a Velociraptor.
It's a Deinonychus.
It's okay. It's a Deinonychus. I'm gonna eat you.